I reach the pinnacle of success in the business world. In others' eyes, my life is an epitome of success. However, aside from work, I have little joy. In the end, wealth is only a fact of life that I accustomed to. At this moment, lying in the sick bed and recalling my whole life, I realized that all the recognition and wealth that I took so much pride in have failed and become meaningless in the face of impending death. In the darkness, I look at the green lights from the life supporting machines, and here in the handling of mechanical cells, I can feel the breath of God of the dead drawing closer. Now I know, and we have accumulated sufficient wealth to last our lifetime, we should pursue. As the mothers that are unrelated to wealth, should be something that is more important. Perhaps relationships, perhaps art, perhaps opinion from other things. Let's stop pursuing wealth to only turn a person into a twisted being just like me. Consensus. Let us build the love in everyone's heart. Not the illusions brought about my wealth. The wealth I have bought in my life, I can bring with me. What I can bring is knowing the memories precipitated by love. That's the true riches will follow you, accompany you, giving you strength and light to go on. Wealth can travel 1,000 miles. Life has no limit. Go where you want to go, reach the height you want to reach. It is in all your heart and in your hand. What is the most expensive bed in the world? Sick bed. You can employ someone to drive the car for you, make money for you. But you cannot have someone to bear the sickness for you. Material things lost can be found. But there is one thing that can never be found when it is lost. Life. When a person goes into the operating room, he will realize that there is one book that he needs yet to finish reading. Book of Helpful Life. Whichever stage in life we are at right now, with time, we will face the day where the curtain comes down. Treasure love for your family, love for your spouse, love for your friends. Treat yourself well, cherish hugging.